लाइव
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग प्रमोद सर, वैभव सर, जयंत सर एंड ऑल माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे वी हैव मिस्टर वैभव जैन सर विद अस, हु इज अ प्रोग्राम लीडर इन कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग एट JLU. His designation is Assistant Professor and Program Leader, Department of CSE, School of Engineering and Technology, JLU. He is pursuing PhD and completed M.Tech in Computer Science, CSE and BE. His area of specialization is Artificial Intelligence, Machine Learning, Deep Learning, Image Processing. He has worked a lot in his field and almost 12 plus research papers are being published. He is a postgraduate from RGPV and he has also worked as junior research fellow in BRNS DAE project sanctioned by the President of India at Nirma University, Ahmedabad. He is the member of IEEE. He has published 12 research papers and book chapters, including in Springer CICS. He has also been awarded with the Best Faculty Award in year 2014-15 by Srijan Technical Society, Bhopal. His field of specialization are artificial intelligence, machine learning, and deep learning. Currently, his research is based on applications of deep learning in smart cities. In addition to experience in academia, he has worked as member of anti-ragging committee, social media coordinator in various institutions.
Thank you very much, ma'am, for introducing me. Good morning to all of you. Hello, students. I am Vaibhav Jain, as ma'am has told that I am working as program leader in computer science and engineering department at the School of Engineering and Technology, Jagran Lake City University, Bhopal. So I would like to start with the very basic of artificial intelligence. But before going with artificial intelligence, I would like to tell you about something about its parent, which is known as what, engineering. So before going with AI and machine learning, I would like to tell you very basic thing, what is engineering, because AI has came from engineering only, right? So we are going to start with very basic thing, that is what, engineering. So I know many of you are from the math field. It may be possible that many of you want to be engineers, right, in their future. So for those students who are willing to take their career as the engineer, I am going to start with very basic thing as engineering. So what is engineering? In my view, engineering is a smart way to do anything, right? So we are going through a, you know, very good example in kind of a story, right? So here I have given you a story. Let's understand a very short story. There are two persons, person A and person B, right? They applied for the same job, right? So there are two persons, person A and person B. They applied for the same job, right? Person A, he is well prepared with the exact fact and figures, means it is having all the data, all the kind of facts, all the kind of figures he is having with him, right? And one is what, person B. Person B is only having, you know, some preparation for the interview, but he is not having that kind of facts and figure which person A is having, right? So there are two persons, fine. Person A is having all the facts and figures and he is well prepared for the interview, but person B is prepared for interview, but he is not having all the facts and figures. So what happened next? Like, so suppose their interviews take place near Qutub Minar. Have you listened about Qutub Minar? It's a very great place in Delhi. So suppose interview is taking place near Qutub Minar, right? So person A, he enters in the interviewer room, right? He's having all the facts and figures. So he enters in the interview room and then interviewer asks him, can you please tell me the exact height of Qutub Minar, right? Then person A tells that the height of Qutub Minar is ABC. Whatever the height is, he tells exactly. Why? Because he has memorized that particular height. He has all the facts and figures, right? That's why he has given the exact answer, right? But what about person B? Let's see, what about person B? So this is that Qutub Minar about which I am talking. Now it's a chance to person B. Now person B enters into your room, then the same question has been asked to him. What is the height of Qutub Minar? Right? So when he has been asked such kind of question, he asks the interviewer to give him some kind of time. He asks the interviewer, please give me some time. I will calculate the height and will tell you soon. Then he leaves the room and go to the Qutub Minar. Can you imagine what he had did? He had did what? He had just measured the shadow of that Qutub Minar and he has applied some trigonometric formula. With the help of that trigonometric formula, he has calculated the height of Qutub Minar. Then he enters into the room again of interviewer and tells the exact height of that particular Qutub Minar to the interviewer. Right? And believe me, the height told by that particular person B was almost exact what they have expected. Right? So what is who is the winner? Who has cleared the interview as per your view? Person A or person B? Person A has given the answer because of his facts and figures, what he has memorized, but person B has done some practical kind of work, right? So who is the winner? Who has cleared the interview? Yes, person B has cleared that particular interview, right? So the person who solves the problem, right? That particular person wins the interview kind of thing, right? That person do not win who memorized that particular answer, right? So this is what engineering. Engineering is not about taking anything into the memory. It is not taking in anything into the facts and figures. Rather than solving a real life problem, this is known as what? Engineering, right? So person B, obviously, person B has cleared the interview because he is having the problem solving skill, right? He has gone to the Qutub Minar, then he has found out the trigonometric formula, then he has calculated the height of that Qutub Minar. So interviewer found him more suitable rather than the person who has figured out just through his data or just through his memory. So this is known as what? Engineering. So for me, what is engineering? And for you, it should be also engineering. Engineering in one word is known as what? It is the ability, or engineering is also all about engineering skills. It is all about engineering skills. What are the engineering skills? The engineering skills are nothing. Person B, he has gone to Qutub Minar. He has just applied the trigonometric formula. He has just calculated the height of that Qutub Minar. So this is the capability to solve the problem. So yes, capability to solve the problem. Yadi aapke andar capability to solve the problem hai, you are having a engineering skill. Yadi aapke andar kisi problem ko understand karne ki capability hai, so you are having an engineer skill, right? So your capability to understand the problem, your capability to solve the problem, your ability to make best out of waste. आपने सुना होगा किसी engineer ने क्या किया? Waste से कोई useful चीज को बनाकर उसको use कर लिया. This is known as what? Best out of waste. So whatever the wasted thing we are having, we can just extract the best from them. This is the ability of an engineer. So engineering is nothing. It is a smarter way to perform any kind of task, right? It is not only scoring the marks and getting placed. It is just beyond limit of any kind of things, like you are making some kind of invention, you are making some kind of discovery, which may be helpful for the society, which may be helpful for the nation. This is known as what? Engineering, right? So engineering is a way to perform any task in a smarter way, right? मैं आपको एक छोटा सा एग्जाम्पल देता हूँ. मुझे अपना एक घर बनवाना है, right? मैं क्या करूंगा, मैं अपनी गाड़ी लेकर जाऊंगा एंड आई विल हायर टू लेबर फ्रॉम द मार्केट. मैंने दो लेबर्स को हायर किया और मैं उनको अपने घर बनवाने के लिए ले गया, राइट? जैसे ही मैंने उनसे बोला कि ये मेरा मटेरियल है, आप घर बनाना स्टार्ट करिए, राइट? नाउ केस टू सुनिए. मैंने दो लेबर को हायर नहीं किया, मैंने सबसे पहले एक आर्किटेक्ट को हायर किया. आर्किटेक्ट ने मेरे घर का एक मैप बनाया, उसके बाद उसने मुझे बताया कि व्हाट शुड बी द पैरामीटर आई शुड फॉलो during the development of this particular building. Then I have gone through that particular parameters and then I have find out such kind of material with such kind of strength. So which is the better way? Way A or way B? A way was what? I had two persons and I have given them the material. They have just started to prepare the building. I think better way will be what? B. Why? Because in B way, what I have did, I have just, you know, go through a plan. This is known as what engineering. Engineering mein kya hota hai, koi bhi cheez ek sequential manner mein perform hoti hai. Na ki bilkul ekdam se kisi bhi cheez ko jab hum start karte hain, so it should be start with a planning. It should be start with a proper strategy. This is known as what engineering. Isse kya hota hai? जब भी कहीं अर्थक्वेक आएगा या कोई काइंड ऑफ यू नो डिजास्टर आएगा तो मेरा जो घर होगा वो बहुत देर तक सरवाइव कर जाएगा इन कंपैरिजन ऑफ दैट होम व्हिच हैज बीन बिल्ड विदाउट एनी स्ट्रेटेजी राइट दिस इज नॉन एज व्हाट इंजीनियरिंग इंजीनियरिंग ऑलवेज फॉलोज अ सीक्वेंस इंजीनियरिंग ऑलवेज फॉलोज अ प्रॉपर वे सो दैट इट कैन लॉन्ग लास्ट राइट इट कैन मेक सम काइंड ऑफ यू नो लॉन्ग ड्यूरेबिलिटी दिस इज नॉन एज व्हाट इंजीनियरिंग सो बिफोर इंजीनियरिंग You can just have a basic knowledge of mathematics. You can just have a basic knowledge of physics and chemistry. Then you will have a lot of problem solving skills. This is all about engineering, right? So before going with artificial intelligence again, I would like to come one more point, which is known as what? Computer science and engineering, right? Dekhi, artificial intelligence or machine learning. Uske jo parents hain, they are known as what? Computer science engineering. Aur uske jo grandparents hain, they are known as what? Engineering, right? So I should come to the artificial intelligence, then you should know what is computer science and engineering. So aaj ke time aap, you all people are equipped with the laptops, you all people are equipped with the, you know, desktop, you all people are equipped with the kind of smartphones. So all these are the application of nothing. They are the applications of computer science and engineering. In your daily life, you have a lot of applications which moves around the computer science and engineering. So I will just come to the what is computer science and engineering. Whenever we solve any problem with our programming skill, it is known as what computer science and engineering, right? मुझे कोई एक particular दो number को add करने वाला एक program बनाने को कहा गया. It is the application of computer science and engineering. Suppose करिए there are two numbers, right? One and two. What should be the answer? Three. How I have calculated? Because I know it. I have learned from the childhood. One plus two is what? Three. But the same thing I want to perform with my system. I have to give the input at 1 and 2. Then I will instruct the system to add these two numbers. How the system will calculate the addition of these two numbers? With the help of program that I have explicitly made. This is known as what? Computer science and engineering. Right? So computer science and engineering is nothing. It is just provide a way to provide the better computing solution for the practical problem. Right? I have mentioned the definition of computer science. Now the most important point is what scope and career in computer science engineering. So you know what, like you have also listened, a lot of your elder sisters or brothers are working as a software engineering, right? So it is a first and very traditional kind of career opportunity for a computer science engineering, right? Second one is what? Database management. It is a computer science engineering, another kind of career opportunity. Third one is what? Web designing. If you are interested in game, you can develop the game, so you may be a game developer. So there are a lot of scope in computer science and engineering. But my dear student, in last few years, the trend has been changed. How the trend has been changed? Let me show you. You can see on your screen, what are the top career opportunities for our computer science engineering in last few years and in future few years? I should say, up to 2024, that has been recorded by the World Economic Forum. The World Economic Forum is the biggest forum who tells about a lot of career opportunities and kind of job trending and what are the kind of economy. So a lot of things has been, you know, manipulated with from their end. So they have just mentioned that artificial intelligence and machine learning specialist is the biggest career opportunity till 2024. You can just see here one more career opportunity, which is known as what data analytics and scientist. And what about the traditional career opportunity of computer science engineering, which is known as what? Software engineering. It has came to the 0.4. Can you see on your screen? Number 4 par software engineering aa chuki hai, jabki number 2 par aa chuka hai artificial intelligence and machine learning specialist. So students, computer science engineering mein aaj ke samay jo sabse ek, you know, I should say, latest trend chal raha hai career opportunity ka, wo hai artificial intelligence and machine learning. So I am coming to the point. I am coming to the main objective of this particular session, which is known as what? Artificial intelligence and machine learning. So before coming to artificial intelligence and machine learning, I would like to show you some examples. Can you see on your screen what I have shown you? Yeah, there are four things I have mentioned on the screen. One is what? Hey Alexa. Second is what? Hey Siri. Third one is what? Hey Google. And the fourth one is what? Hey Cortana. So what are these? Have you ever listened about that? Yes. They all are known as what? Voice assistant, or I should say smart voice assistant. What are these? These have been installed on your Android phone. They have been installed on your Apple. They have been installed on your iPhone. They have been installed on your laptop. They have been installed on your Echo, Amazon Echo, whatever you have called it, Alexa. Yes, they all are voice assistant. What they do? They will do the same thing as the human do, right? A human will ask to Alexa, hey Alexa, please show me a best movie of this year. And Alexa will just search out that particular movie and it will give the reply to that particular human. So what is happening here? They are just working as a smart voice assistant in order to help the human, just like another human, right? So they are just doing everything which a human do, right? I have to just find out the best restaurant near me. What I will do? I will just pick my iPhone. I will just call it, hey Siri, please tell me the best restaurant near me within 500 meters. It will give a lot of choice to me within that 500 meters that I am having the following restaurant. I have to book a cab. So what I have to do? I don't have to move even my fingers on my iPhone. I will just ask, hey Siri, please book me a cab. It will just book me a cab instantly without having any kind of delay. This is known as what? Smart voice assistant. And this is the best application of artificial intelligence nowadays, right? Another one application I would like to tell you. A lady showing on your screen. Can you recognize who is that lady? Yes, that lady is nothing. That lady is Sophia. She is not a realistic lady. She is known as what? Sophia. She is the first lady robotics of the world, which has been developed by a company which is known as what? Hanson Robotics, right? It is a Hong Kong based company who have developed the first lady robot. Can you see that particular lady robot? She can just, you know, talk to you. She can just, you know, talk to you like a normal person. She can answer you everything. What you will ask, she can answer. If you will ask, how are you? She will answer, I'm fine. If you will ask, how are you doing? What is the temperature of today? She will give the temperature. If you will ask, I want a suggestion from you. She will give a lot of suggestions, right? So she is known as Sophia, and she is not a lady. She is a robotic lady, right? She is a humanoid robot, which will reply you as just like a human being, right? So this was the first kind of lady robot in the history, which can just, you know, simulate all the kind of things which a human can. This is known as Sophia. This is the best example of artificial intelligence machine learning till now. Okay, so I will give you a lot of examples which are related to the field of artificial intelligence. But before going with these examples, I would like to tell you how artificial intelligence works. What is artificial intelligence, right? So these were the examples, right? I have not told you yet what is artificial intelligence. So artificial intelligence is made of two words. One is what? Artificial. Another is what? Intelligence, right? One word is known as what? Artificial. Another is what? Intelligence. Are you intelligent? Tap intelligent hai? Yes. I am intelligent? Yes. God has gifted us the intelligence. God ne hame intelligence diya hua hai. Right? But what about that intelligence? Ye jo intelligence hame God ne diya hai, this is natural intelligence. Right? Ek intelligence hum banate hain computer ko. Ek intelligence hum banate hain apne mobile ko. Ek intelligence hum banate hain apne laptop ko. That is known as what? Artificial intelligence. Whenever we make the machine intelligent, just like human, it is known as what? Artificial intelligence, right? The question is, why we need to machine intelligent? The question rises, why we need the machine to be an intelligent, right? So I'm just giving you an example. You will like, suppose I have to find out the best movie of 2020, right? What I will do? I will just make the Google search, right? You will also do that, right? So I will just type this, please give me the best movie of 2020. It will give me a lot of movies, but the movies with the highest rating, it will be just above the, all above the other kind of thing. And if I will select it in future, whenever I will go to that particular Google search, it will give me automatically the recommender. It will just give me the automatically the top movie of that particular year without asking. this is what? This is artificial intelligence. All the recommender system, all the face recognition system, all the biometric system, all these are based on artificial intelligence. So what is artificial intelligence? Artificial intelligence is nothing, just to make a system smarter in order to providing the intelligence to a machine. It is known as what? Artificial intelligence. The machine human ki tarah work karne lage, it is known as what? Artificial intelligence. I am giving you an example. Jab main chota tha, to mere ghar mein ek uncle aaye, right? Meri mummy ne bola, beta pehchano ye kaun hai? I can't get him. Mujhe nahi pata wo kaun hai. To meri mummy ne mujhe sikhaya, right? बोले बेटा ये रमेश अंकल है, इनको पहचान. मैंने कहा ओके राइट. नेक्स्ट टाइम वो फिर से अंकल आए मेरे घर में, राइट. मैंने उनसे बोला कि मम्मी ये कौन है? उन्होंने कहा बेटा लास्ट टाइम भी तो आए थे, पहचानो आप. मैंने कहा अच्छा ओ तो महेश अंकल है ये. मम्मी बोली नहीं बेटा ये रमेश अंकल है, आपने गलत बताया है, ही इज नॉट महेश, ही इज रमेश. सो व्हाट इज हैपनिंग हियर, माय मदर इज टीचिंग मी एंड आई एम लर्निंग, राइट. आई एम डूइंग द मिस्टेक बट शी इज करेक्टिंग मी अगेन एंड अगेन. This is known as what? Machine. This is known as what? Learning by a human. In the same manner, I learned to the system. The system learned by our input. In the same manner, system learned from our data. Right? So, इसी manner में computer को भी हम सिखाते हैं कि this is the data which I want. This is the input which will give the output. This is known as what? Machine learning. So, artificial intelligence का एक tool होता है machine learning. Machine learning is nothing, just to make the system learn. So that system can give the output on your any kind of input, right? मैं system से पूछूं, what is the nearest restaurant to me? So I have given an input in past, that these are the restaurants which are located in 1 kilometer area. Then on the basis of that input, system has learned and system will give me the output. This is the best restaurant nearby you. So computer machine को मैंने intelligent बनाया. This is known as what? Artificial intelligence. तो आप इंटेलिजेंट कैसे बनाएंगे? जस्ट लाइक वैसे जैसे मम्मी ने मुझे मेरे सिखाया था कि ये रमेश है, ये महेश है, ये है, तो उसी तरीके से हम कंप्यूटर को भी रॉ डेटा देंगे. आप अपने आपकी स्क्रीन पे आपको दिख रहा होगा, लर्न फ्रॉम द पास्ट डेटा. योर मशीन लर्न फ्रॉम द पास्ट डेटा एंड देन व्हाट हैपेंस, इट गिव्स द आंसर. बट इट मे नॉट बी पॉसिबल दैट एवरी टाइम इट गिव्स द करेक्ट आंसर. सो वी हैव टू गिव द फीडबैक टू अवर मशीन. ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट फीडबैक कंप्यूटर विल अपडेट इटसेल्फ and it will give a updated output. It may be a correct one also. This is known as what? Machine learning. How to make a system learn so that it can take the decision like us, it can give the answer of our question, it can take any kind of, you know, assistance from human kind of thing. So this is known as what? Artificial intelligence and machine learning. Apne system ko intelligent banana human ki tarah, so that human ki tarah wo answer de sake, human ki tarah wo decision le sake, ह्यूमन की तरह वो हमें असिस्ट कर सके. दिस इज नॉन एज वॉट आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस, राइट. सो हियर अ लॉट ऑफ एग्जांपल ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस एंड मशीन लर्निंग हैव बीन गिवन. आप लोग यदि मेल आपने कभी चलाया हो, जीमेल आपने कभी यूज किया हो, इन जीमेल वी हैव अ फैसिलिटी ऑफ स्पैम डिटेक्शन. बट इन स्पैम डिटेक्शन द अनवॉन्टेड मेल गोज टू द स्पैम. दिस इज नॉन एज वॉट स्पैम डिटेक्शन, राइट. सो स्पैम डिटेक्शन ऑटोमेटिकली कर दिया जाता है जीमेल में. कोई भी मेल आएगा और यदि गूगल को लगेगा इट इज अ स्पैम, वो ऑटोमेटिकली स्पैम नाम के फोल्डर में चला जाएगा. दिस इज नॉन एज द बेस्ट एग्जांपल ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस एंड मशीन लर्निंग. सो स्पैम डिटेक्शन इज एग्जांपल ऑफ एआई. टेस्ला की सेल्फ ड्राइविंग कार आई है, इट इज एग्जांपल ऑफ एआई. विदाउट ड्राइवर द कार रन्स, दिस इज द बेस्ट एग्जांपल ऑफ एआई, वन ऑफ द बेस्ट एग्जांपल ऑफ एआई, व्हिच इज नॉन एज व्हाट सेल्फ ड्राइविंग कार ऑफ टेस्ला. इट इज ऑल्सो एग्जांपल ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस. Credit card fraud detection, it is an example of artificial intelligence. Amazon and Netflix, I know many of you have subscribed to Netflix, right? So Netflix is also an example of artificial intelligence. Why? Because it recommended the movie to you, right? It recommends a movie to you on the basis of the past choices which you have made in your previous time, right? So it is a recommender system which recommends the best movie to you. It is an artificial intelligence application. Facebook, it is an application of artificial intelligence. How? Whenever you see the Facebook timeline, you will always see the relevant video to you. You will never see the video which are not relevant to you. You will always see the advertisement which are relevant to you. This is the example of artificial intelligence. Amazon Alexa. Have you listened about Amazon Alexa? Okay, it is a device from Amazon to whom I can say that personal voice assistant. So So I will just ask, hey Alexa, please tell me the breaking news. It will just give you a breaking news. Please tell me the Hindi song. It will just play the Hindi song. So this is known as what? Artificial intelligence. Another application which is known as what? Amazon Alexa. And the next and last one, I hope many of you are there, which is known as what? Instagram. Do you know Instagram? Instagram is also one of the application of machine learning and artificial intelligence. So these are the basic applications of artificial intelligence which you are using nowadays around you in your daily life, in your daily routine. So these are a lot of applications of artificial intelligence which we are going to see in future, right? So we are starting how the artificial intelligence can be achieved. Abhi tak maine aapko kya kya bataya? I have just told you what is engineering. I have just told you what is computer science and engineering. I have just told you what is artificial intelligence, right? Ab baat aati hai ki artificial intelligence ko hum implement kaise kare? Artificial intelligence ko hum apply kaise kare? Artificial intelligence ke apply karne ke kya kya tool hai? Ab baat aati hai ye, right? So artificial intelligence ko achieve karne ke liye hame sabse zaruri jo tool chahiye hai, usko hum bolte hain machine learning. Yes, machine learning is what? Apne machine ko learn karana so that it can take any kind of input and can give any kind of output. It can make a decision for us. It can make a kind of, you know, choice for us. It can give anything of result from the learning what we have provided to it. This is known as what? Machine learning, which is a tool of artificial intelligence, right? So we are going to start with machine learning, right? On your screen, what you are seeing here? On your screen, just a minute. Yeah, on your screen, you are just seeing that there is a machine. The thing which has been kept in between, that is a machine. In that machine, I am giving the input of 4 dogs images, right? How many dogs are there? 4 images of dogs are there. And I am giving in these images as an input to that particular machine, right? The machine will learn from these 4 images, right? कि these 4 images belongs to which category? Dog category, right? तो मैंने system को सिखा दिया कि ये जो मैंने 4 images दी हैं, ये किसकी image हैं? Dog की हैं। ऐसा मैंने system को सिखा दिया, right? अब जब भी मैं उसको किसी नई image को system को दूंगा as an input, system will identify whether it is dog or not. Are you getting my point? This is known as what? Machine learning, right? What is happening? Again, I am telling you, I have given 4 images of dog as an input to system. Right? And the system has learned from these 4 images, right? Ki what is that? And I have made one input also, ki all these 4 images belongs to which category? They belongs to a category which is dog, right? Whenever I will give a new image of dog to system, system will identify and search in its system whether it is a present or not. Whenever the image will match from its database, it will give us the answer that this particular image belongs to dog. राइट सो सिस्टम ने आइडेंटिफाई कर लिया कि यस दिस इज अ डॉग मैंने एक और किसी डॉग की इमेज दी सिस्टम ने आइडेंटिफाई कर लिया यस दिस इज अ डॉग मैंने एक कैट की इमेज दी सिस्टम ने अपने डेटाबेस में सर्च किया सिस्टम को वो इमेज कहीं भी नहीं मिली तो सिस्टम ने कह दिया दिस इज नॉट डॉग आर यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट सो दिस इज समथिंग व्हाट इज नॉन एज व्हाट मशीन लर्निंग वी गिव द रॉ डेटा टू द सिस्टम सिस्टम लर्न फ्रॉम देम सिस्टम ट्रेंड फ्रॉम देम एंड देन सिस्टम विल गिव द आउटपुट ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ अवर input. This is known as what? Machine learning, right? So machine learning कैसे काम करती है? We give the training data to the system. आप ऊपर से देखिए, ऊपर से start करिए. We give the training data to the system, right? System learn from that data, and system develop a model, and then system provides applies the machine learning algorithm. और फिर हम उसको एक नया input देते हैं, और उस input के basis पे वो predict करता है what is the input. And what is the class of input to which it belongs, right? If the system can identify the exact class, very fine. If it is not able to find out the exact class, then we give the thumbs down kind of thing. We give a negative feedback that you have not identified the right answer. Then system again trains. System can again learn how we can improve our result. This process happens in a loop. This is known as what? Machine learning, right? So मैंने machine learning में क्या किया? सिस्टम को ढेर सारा डेटा दिया सिस्टम ने उस डेटा से सीखा फिर मैंने सिस्टम को एक नया डेटा दिया और मैंने कहा पहचानो इसको ये क्या है सिस्टम ने यदि उसको सही आइडेंटिफाई कर लिया वेल एंड गुड यदि सिस्टम ने उसको आइडेंटिफाई नहीं किया तो हमने सिस्टम को फीडबैक दिया कि दिस डेटा डज नॉट बिलोंग टू दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग विच यू आर टेलिंग टू मी तो उसने फिर अपने उसमें अपडेट किया और फिर मुझे नेक्स्ट टाइम सही डेटा प्रोवाइड करने की कोशिश करेगा. सो दिस इज अ कंटिन्यूस प्रोसेस, राइट. सिस्टम नेवर स्टॉप लर्निंग, लाइक ह्यूमन नेवर स्टॉप लर्निंग. जैसे इंसान कभी लर्निंग स्टॉप नहीं करते हैं, सिस्टम भी कभी लर्निंग स्टॉप नहीं करते हैं. दे कंटिन्यूस लर्न ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ फीडबैक प्रोवाइडेड फ्रॉम द यूजर, राइट. सो दिस इज नॉन एज वॉट मशीन लर्निंग वर्किंग. बट एक चीज है, इसमें मैंने चार इमेजेस दी डॉग की एंड सिस्टम को बोला आइडेंटिफाई करो कि एक नई इमेज मैंने सिस्टम को दी और मैंने सिस्टम को बोला आइडेंटिफाई करो ये क्या है. सिस्टम ने मुझे बता दिया ये डॉग है. कैसे आइडेंटिफाई किया? बिकॉज उन चारों इमेज में से एक इमेज मिलती जुलती उसी डॉग की प्रेजेंट थी जो मैंने इनपुट में दी थी. तो सिस्टम हैज आइडेंटिफाइड दिस इज डॉग. बट व्हाट हैपेंस व्हेन द इमेज इज नॉट प्रेजेंट इन इट्स डेटाबेस, राइट. मैंने सिस्टम को एक नई इमेज दी और इसमें एक नया टाइप का डॉग आ गया. कैन यू सी दैट पर्टिकुलर डॉग? इट्स अ न्यू काइंड ऑफ डॉग विच आई हैव प्रोवाइडेड एज अ इनपुट टू माई सिस्टम, राइट. अब सिस्टम कैसे आइडेंटिफाई करेगा? ऐसा डॉग तो उसके डेटाबेस में है नहीं है, तो वो कैसे आइडेंटिफाई करेगा whether it is dog or not? Yes, machine learning get little bit failed here and a new version of machine learning comes into the scenario which is known as what deep learning, right. So machine learning ka bhi ek superset aa chuka hai artificial intelligence mein which is known as what deep learning, right. Deep learning is a kind of learning technique of artificial intelligence which does not require exact feature, exact kind of image, exact kind of data, whatever we given as a input, right. It can also use mixture of the present image and combine them to inject a new feature automatically. This is known as what deep learning, right. So artificial intelligence ka tools are machine learning, lekin abhi uska ek advanced version chal raha hai jisko kya bola gaya hai, deep learning. What is the properties of deep learning? Deep learning identifies the feature automatically, right. It doesn't require any, you know, implicit features. It requires just training and training and training, and then it gets trained by itself and it learns the feature automatically, right. This is known as what deep learning. So right now what is trending? Machine learning has been little bit, you know, kind of studied. Now the deep learning has come into the picture. Deep learning is trending nowadays. It's a new way to achieve artificial intelligence, राइट. सो आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस को अचीव करने के मैंने आपको दो तरीके बताए. फर्स्ट वन इज व्हाट मशीन लर्निंग एंड सेकंड वन इज व्हाट डीप लर्निंग. डीप लर्निंग इज अ सुपरसेट ऑफ मशीन लर्निंग? नो, इट इज सबसेट ऑफ मशीन लर्निंग, राइट. मशीन लर्निंग का सबसेट है लेकिन मशीन लर्निंग से ज्यादा पावरफुल है. व्हाई? बिकॉज इट इज हैविंग अ लॉट ऑफ फीचर्स लाइक ऑटोमेटिक फीचर डिटेक्शन, लाइक नंबर ऑफ हिडन लेयर, अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स हैव बीन इंप्रूव्ड देयर, दैट इज नॉट एज व्हाट डीप लर्निंग. अब डीप लर्निंग से क्या फायदा हुआ? ये जो डॉग है, इन माई लास्ट स्लाइड, ये जो डॉग है ये मेरे डेटाबेस में नहीं था लेकिन फिर भी मेरे डेटाबेस ने उसको आइडेंटिफाई करके दे दिया ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ डीप लर्निंग. कैसे आइडेंटिफाई किया? उसने दो डॉग के फीचर को कंबाइन किया. हो सकता है उसमें से कोई ना कोई फीचर तो इस पर्टिकुलर डॉग से मैच कर जाए. दिस इज द वर्किंग ऑफ डीप लर्निंग एंड दिस टेक्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ लॉट ऑफ लेयर्स विच इज नॉन एज वॉट हिडन लेयर्स, राइट. ये देखिए आपकी स्क्रीन पे अभी सामने एक नेटवर्क दिख रहा है. ये जो नेटवर्क है ये मशीन लर्निंग का नेटवर्क है. इसमें एक इनपुट लेयर होती है, एक आउटपुट लेयर होती है, राइट, और एक हिडन लेयर होती है. लेकिन जब हम डीप लर्निंग की बात करते हैं तो ये जो बीच वाली लेयर्स हैं ये बढ़ जाती हैं. नंबर ऑफ हिडन लेयर्स हैव बीन इंप्रूव्ड. जितनी ज्यादा हिडन लेयर होंगी आपके सिस्टम की लर्निंग एंड ट्रेनिंग उतनी अच्छी होगी. दिस इज नॉन एज वॉट डीप लर्निंग एंड मशीन लर्निंग, राइट. सो हियर आई हैव कंपेयर्ड बोथ मशीन लर्निंग एंड डीप लर्निंग. इन मशीन लर्निंग देयर इज ओनली वन हिडन लेयर, बट इन डीप लर्निंग अ नंबर ऑफ हिडन लेयर्स आर देयर. इसी वजह से ये जो डॉग यहाँ पे प्रेजेंट नहीं था उसकी इमेज को भी आइडेंटिफाई कर लिया हमारी मशीन ने ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ प्रेजेंट इमेजेस ऑफ द डॉग. दिस इज नॉन एज वॉट डीप लर्निंग. सो नाउडेज अब हम मशीन लर्निंग से किसकी तरफ मूव कर चुके हैं? वी हैव शिफ्टेड टुवर्ड्स द डीप लर्निंग, राइट. मशीन लर्निंग इज नॉट इन दैट मच यूज नाउडेज रादर देन वी आर यूजिंग डीप लर्निंग. बट डीप लर्निंग हैव अ लिमिट. लिमिटेशन इज दैट we should have a large kind of data for the deep learning, right. It doesn't work on a small data. We should have a large kind of data. After that the deep learning will work finely. So this is the only limitation of deep learning. Otherwise the deep learning is very far better than the machine learning, right. So here I have just make them compare kaise deep learning machine learning se different hoti hai. Theek hai, machine learning provides a manual feature extraction बट डीप लर्निंग प्रोवाइड ऑटोमेटिक फीचर एक्सट्रैक्शन. जब हम मशीन लर्निंग परफॉर्म करते हैं तो मुझे बताना होता है कि ये डॉग की आई है, ये डॉग का ईयर है, ये डॉग के लेग्स है. बट इन डीप लर्निंग वी डोंट हैव टू सिस्टम टेल्स अबाउट एनी काइंड ऑफ फीचर ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर कार, पर्टिकुलर डॉग, पर्टिकुलर कैट. वी जस्ट विल गिव द इनपुट एज अ इमेज एंड इट विल जस्ट ऑटोमेटिकली एक्सटेंड द फीचर एंड इट विल गिव यू द आउटपुट एज दिस इज द कार, दिस इज द डॉग, दिस इज द कैट. तो उसमें हमें सिस्टम को सिखाने की जरूरत ही नहीं है कि ये कार का व्हील है, ये कार की स्टेपनी है. इट विल ऑटोमेटिकली डिटेक्ट एवरी फीचर. इट इज नॉट अबाउट डीप लर्निंग, राइट. सो एआई को अचीव करने के मैंने आपको दो तरीके बताए. आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस को दो तरीके से हम इंप्लीमेंट कर सकते हैं. वन इज व्हाट मशीन लर्निंग, अनदर इज व्हाट डीप लर्निंग. सो डोंट बी कंफ्यूज. कंफ्यूज होने की जरूरत नहीं है, राइट. आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस इज अ सुपरसेट. जब भी हम किसी मशीन को इंटेलिजेंट बनाते हैं जस्ट लाइक अ ह्यूमन, इट इज नॉन इज व्हाट आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस. और उसको इंटेलिजेंट बनाने का जो टूल होता है, मतलब जो उसका सबसेट होता है, इट इज नॉन इज व्हाट मशीन लर्निंग. मशीन लर्निंग का भी एक सबसेट होता है जो बिल्कुल लेटेस्ट ट्रेंड है, इट इज नॉन इज व्हाट डीप लर्निंग. तो ऑल थ्री पर्टिकुलर टर्म्स आर डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ईच अदर. डोंट बी कंफ्यूज, दे आर नॉट सेम. इन फ्यूचर समबडी मे आस्क यू व्हाट इज आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस एंड व्हाट मशीन लर्निंग, वेदर दे आर सेम और नॉट. नो, दे आर नॉट सेम. आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस इज अ सुपरसेट, मशीन लर्निंग इज अ सबसेट एंड इट वर्क एज अ टूल फॉर द आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस. And deep learning is a subset of machine learning, which work as a faster method in order to recognize any object rather than machine learning. So there are three terms and all are different. Don't get confused between these three terms, right? So just I am telling you many more uses of the artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is getting used in a lot of sectors, in a lot of areas, right? The best example we can give here, like artificial intelligence is working for the good. How it can work for the good? Yes, it is working for a good. Do you know how? Yes, NASA. Have you listened about NASA? Have you listened about ISRO? Yeah. They are working on a project, right? They are taking the help of satellite images, right? In order to find out the areas, right, where the poor people are living. Can you imagine what they are doing? They are just finding out, they are just trying out to find out the areas where the poor people live in a majority part, just because with the help of satellite images, right? This is the artificial intelligence. Fine. They are taking the help of satellite images in order to find out the areas which are suffering from the poverty. Fine. Next best example of artificial intelligence: aviation. When you go to the flight, right? When you are about to board to the flight, what happens nowadays? What is happening? The boarding pass gets generated automatically from the machine, right? It doesn't require any kind of manual process, right? Also, at the same time, you know, automatic generation or allocation of the gate to the flight. This is also example of artificial intelligence. If उन्होंने machine learning की algorithm apply करके रखी हुई है, जो flight को automatic gate allocate कर देता है कि this particular flight will depart from this particular gate. So this is a self-learning algorithm. जो ये चेक कर लेता है कि वेदर द गेट इज फ्री और नॉट, और उसके बाद उस पर्टिकुलर फ्लाइट को डिपार्चर के लिए वो गेट एलोकेट कर देता है. दिस इज आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस. एजुकेशन. इन एजुकेशन ऑल्सो एआई इज टेकिंग अ लॉट ऑफ प्लेस, राइट. टूडेज द फैकल्टीज आर नॉट फिजिकल फैकल्टीज. यू नो वॉट, रोबोट्स आर टीचिंग टू द स्टूडेंट. कैन यू बिलीव, इन जापान देयर आर टू रोबोट्स हैव बीन प्लेस्ड इन टोक्यो हु टीच टू द स्टूडेंट द बेसिक्स ऑफ द कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स, राइट. So this is something which is far beyond the imagination, right? So education, aviation, AI for good, everywhere AI is working. Now, some other sectors where AI is working, yes, healthcare. Artificial intelligence is also taking place in healthcare also. Do you know, healthcare, COVID, right now the COVID is breaking now. So COVID mein jitne bhi diagnosis ke liye tools use ho rahe hain, foreign mein dekh lein ya kahin bhi dekh lein. That is all artificial intelligence based tool. COVID ke prediction mein, COVID ke diagnosis mein, COVID ki find out, you know, symptoms ko detect karne ke liye, ya fir if we have to take a surveillance of the areas who are suffering under the lockdown through the use of drone, that is also the artificial intelligence, right? Drones are working there. Drones are just taking the picture of areas where the lockdown is going on. drones are detecting whether there is any person or not. This is something which is known as what face detection, which is known as what activity detection. This is also an application of artificial intelligence. So healthcare is taking place with the help of artificial intelligence. Heavy industry, yes, a lot of tools have been taken place of the human there in artificial intelligence. यदि आप देखें बड़ी बड़ी इंडस्ट्री में आज के समय जो मशीनें हैं राइट दे आर टेकिंग प्लेस ऑफ द ह्यूमन राइट आप न्यूज़पेपर की किसी प्रिंटिंग प्रेस में जाएंगे तो वहां पे आपको पता है एक भी इंसान नहीं होता है जो न्यूज़पेपर को टच करता है एवरीथिंग इज मशीनरी काइंड ऑफ मैनर राइट एवरीथिंग टेक प्लेस विद द हेल्प ऑफ मशीन दिस इज नॉट व्हाट हैवी इंडस्ट्री एप्लीकेशन ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस राइट उसके बाद फाइनेंस यस स्टॉक मार्केट प्रेडिक्शन एंड मेनी मोर काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स आर देयर which are the application of artificial intelligence. So these are some sectors where the artificial intelligence belongs. But artificial intelligence is in sectors ko belong nahi karta hai. It serves to our nation. It serves to our society. How? Let's see. You can just take an example of this particular scenario. I'm going to any kind of place where I have to visit through my car. Right? What happens? I have started my GPS location. Right? And my GPS location is current, updating as soon as I am getting to any other places, right? जब भी मैं किसी भी place पे जा रहा हूँ, मेरी GPS location continuously update हो रही है. Suppose करिए, मेरा वहाँ पे accident हो गया, right? I have just started my GPS और मैंने वहाँ पे accident हो गया. What will happen? With the help of my application which I have installed on my system and that particular GPS location, the message will be passed to my relative, right? So your particular relative has been, उनकी कार का एक्सीडेंट हो गया है तो उनके पास एक मैसेज आएगा वो तुरंत उसी चीज से पुलिस को मेरी लोकेशन भेज देंगे और उनको बता देंगे कि प्लीज रीच देयर एम्बुलेंस को लेकर मैसेज भेज देंगे प्लीज रीच देयर विद इन 5 to 10 minutes ऑल द रिलेटिव्स ऑल द पुलिस एम्बुलेंस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स हैव बीन सराउंडेड बाय मी राइट सो दिस इज समथिंग व्हाट इज द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस With the help of that GPS location, Google Map, and very kind of things which are belonging to your mobile as an application, right? They will work immediately and will help it out. This is the best application of artificial intelligence nowadays, right? उसके बाद मैं आपको और भी कुछ दिखाना चाहता हूँ, which is very interesting, right? अभी आपने सुना होगा Amazon के जंगल में बहुत ज़्यादा आग लग गई थी. A lot of fire has been broken out there, right? And it was, not possible for the humans to reach in that particular forest of Amazon, right? Then what is artificial intelligence is helpful there? Yes, artificial intelligence provided us pilotless helicopters, right? And these helicopters may carry out gallons of water there and they can just drop that water in order to, extinguish that particular fire and they can just make the savings of any kind of human life and they just fly it out without any person or without any physical pilot. This is the best, one of the best application of artificial intelligence. Yes, pilotless helicopters without pilot, right? They have been used in order to extinguish the fire in the Amazon forest, right? So this is one of the best application of artificial intelligence. हेलीकॉप्टर्स में कोई भी नहीं बैठा हुआ है कोई भी फिजिकल पर्सन नहीं बैठा हुआ है एंड दे आर कैरिंग गैलन्स ऑफ वाटर इतना वाटर लेके जा रहे हैं वो उस पर्टिकुलर आग को एक्सटिंग्विश करने बुझाने के लिए एंड दे विल डेफिनेटली सेव द लाइफ ऑफ अ लॉट ऑफ ह्यूमन राइट दिस इज नॉन एज वॉट वन ऑफ द एप्लीकेशन विच इज नॉन एज वॉट पायलटलेस हेलीकॉप्टर राइट सो दिस इज अनदर एग्जाम्पल ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस नाउ हियर इज अ सिनेरियो इन विच आई हैव शोन अ फ्लाइट विच हैज बीन हाईजैक इस फ्लाइट को हाईजैक कर लिया गया है क्या आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस यहाँ पे हेल्पफुल हो सकता है यस हाउ यू नो व्हाट आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस हैज प्रोवाइडेड अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स दे हैव प्रोवाइडेड ड्रोन्स दे हैव प्रोवाइडेड रोबोटिक्स स्निपर्स दे हैव प्रोवाइडेड इट लॉट ऑफ काइंड ऑफ फंक्शनैलिटीज लाइक ट्रेन्ड स्निपर्स सो विद द हेल्प ऑफ दीज स्निपर्स दीज आर नॉट ह्यूमन दे आर रोबोट राइट सो वी विल जस्ट सेंड अ ड्रोन इनटू दैट पर्टिकुलर प्लेन राइट एंड ड्रोन विल गिव अ सर्विलेंस टू यू And it will give a view of inside of that particular flight, what is happening inside the flight. It will give the view of that hijacker and then our snipers will follow it, the drone's vigilance, and we can send the robotics snipers also. है, यदि हम रोबोटिक्स नेटवर्क को अंदर भेज देंगे एंड दे कैन जस्ट टेक द प्लेस एंड दे कैन डिस्ट्रॉय द हाइजैकर, दे कैन जस्ट गो थ्रू आउट एंड दे कैन सेव द लाइफ ऑफ अ लॉट ऑफ पर्संस हु आर सिटिंग इन दैट पर्टिकुलर प्लेस. सो देयर आर अ लॉट ऑफ एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस नाउडेज. आई थिंक दीज आर सम इंटरेस्टेड एप्लीकेशंस व्हिच यू आर सीइंग ऑन योर स्क्रीन. अनदर वन एप्लीकेशन, लुक ऑन दीज आर्टिस्टिक पेंटिंग. कैन यू इमेजिन who have drawn these painting, who have painted out these beautiful artistic images? You can't imagine. They have been developed by a program, not any human. These artistic images have been drawn by a help of program, as that program was based on artificial intelligence, right? So this is the best example of artificial intelligence which you can see on your screen. The artistic images have been drawn by a program explicitly, right? We have just given it scenario, and the artificial intelligence machine have drawn out these images. Another example of artificial intelligence is what? Composing the music itself. अपने आप से music compose हो रहा है. We will just give them data. Yeah, I want this particular genre. I want this particular tune. I want this particular lyric, and they will compose it automatically. So artificial intelligence is making everything automatically. Everything, you know, machine-ized. Everything is making with the help of taking place with the help of machine, laptops. लैपटॉप और व्हाटएवर यू आर यूजिंग डिवाइसेस. सो मशीन को इंटेलिजेंट बनाना जस्ट लाइक अ ह्यूमन इज नोन एज व्हाट आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस. आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस में इंप्लीमेंट हम क्या करते हैं, मशीन लर्निंग, राइट. मशीन को लर्न कराना जस्ट लाइक अ ह्यूमन. यदि मशीन एक बार लर्न कर गई, इट विल टेक ऑल द डिसीजन लाइक ह्यूमन, इट विल गिव यू ऑल द रिजल्ट लाइक ह्यूमन, इट विल गिव यू इट विल टेक यू नो वेरी 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 मच लेस टाइम देन अ ह्यूमन ऑल्सो. दिस इज अ बेस्ट property of a machine learning, right? So here you can see a lot of examples. Now what is artificial intelligence engineer? So I have just mentioned here artificial intelligence engineer ki kya kya property hoti hai. They have a good knowledge of programming, they have a good knowledge of software engineering, they have a good knowledge of data science, right? So these are the properties of artificial intelligence engineer. Uske baad yadi hum baat kare ki artificial intelligence engineer ki रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज क्या क्या होती है. सो दे कैन अप्लाई एनी काइंड ऑफ डिप्लॉय मेथड, दे कैन जस्ट अप्लाई द यू नो काइंड ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस एल्गोरिदम, दे कैन जस्ट डेवलप आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस काइंड ऑफ प्रोग्राम. सो एवरीथिंग दे कैन डेवलप एंड दे कैन मेक इट यू नो फैमिलियर विद द ह्यूमन, सो दैट ह्यूमन कैन टेक द हेल्प ऑफ दीज एआई मशीन्स इन ऑर्डर टू मेक एनी डिसीजन, राइट. सो दे आर अ लॉट ऑफ रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस. बट द क्वेश्चन इज, आप सभी के मन में एक क्वेश्चन आने वाला है. And the question is, what should be special in me to become an artificial intelligence engineer? मेरे अंदर क्या खासियत होनी चाहिए कि मैं artificial intelligence engineer बन जाऊँ? So you don't have to need any kind of specialty. You just have need basic mathematical skills which you learn in your 12th class or 12th standard. You just need basic programming skills like C++. Even if you don't know the C++ language at your 12th standard, we will just teach you at the very first year of your engineering, right? So this is something which we want in artificial intelligence. First one is what? Programming skills. They should have a basic knowledge of programming skills. They should have a basic knowledge of programming skills like Python, R, Java, C, C++, any language. If they know, it will be fine with us to make them improvised in order to become an artificial intelligence engineer. Second one, artificial intelligence engineer should be familiar with linear algebra and probability statistics, which you learn in your mathematics of 12th or 11th, right? So that is the another quality which an artificial intelligence engineer want, right? Next one is what? Third one is what? You need a basic knowledge of big data. Do you know what is big data? Anyone of you can tell me what is big data? Okay, so big data is nothing. It is the data stored by the internet. It is the data stored by the cloud. The cloud has been developed over a internet. What is the property of big data? It can have any range. It doesn't have any limitation, right? In our phone, there is only 60 GB memory. The memory has been full, right? What will happen? It will show the low storage. But in big data, you are having unlimited access to the memory over the internet. So you should, in artificial intelligence, there is a lot of data. There is a, you know, volume of data is very heavy here. So we want big data. So you should have a basic knowledge of big data. Next thing, what you want to become artificial intelligence is what? You should have a basic knowledge of algorithm and framework. So these are not things which you want just to enroll in AI. These are the things which you want after become an AI engineer, right? आप AI engineer होने में आपके पास क्या क्या skill होनी चाहिए मैं उसके बारे में बता रहा हूँ. These things will be provided to you at your graduate place where you will go through artificial intelligence engineering, right? So these are the things which you will learn at the place where you are pursuing your graduation, right? And the next thing, what I want to tell you, last and one thing which I want to tell you, the one and important skill of artificial intelligence engineer is known as what? Communication and problem solving skills. Remember my first example, the person B who has gone through Qutub Minar and he has calculated the height of Qutub Minar by his programming or problem solving skills. He has just applied the trigonometric formula. That skill should be inside you also when you are going to be artificial intelligence engineer. You should have a programming solving skills. You should have a problem understanding skills. You should have a skill of innovating a new idea into your mind, and you should have an implementation guts in order to implement that particular idea. So in that manner, an artificial intelligence engineer can serve to the society, can serve to the family, can serve to the nation, right? Okay, next thing what I would like to tell you, skills to become AI engineers has been finished. So this is something which is the difference between an AI engineer salary. And in India, I have mentioned it approximate figure. It's not an exact figure. Our AI engineer salary is 13 lakh per annum in India, right? As per the source I have received from the internet. And in here from the US point of view, it is around, it is in dollars. And that has been taken from a Glassdoor. Yeah, source has been Glassdoor, which is a very famous website. So there I have figured out what is the salary of AI engineer, right? So AI engineers have a lot of potential in order to serve the nation, in order to serve the society, in order to serve their family, whatever they want, they can do everything, right? Okay, so career in artificial intelligence. If I talk about career, what are the job opportunities which I get? I will be an AI developer. If I have pursued the artificial intelligence specialization in BTech, so I will be an AI developer. I will become an AI architect. I will become a machine learning engineer. I will become a data scientist, and I may be a BI developer also, right? So there are a lot of career opportunities for an artificial intelligence engineer. And I would like to share one more thing with you, that fortunately, you are also having that particular opportunity to become an AI engineer at our Jagran Lake City University, which provided the specialization of artificial intelligence and machine learning in BTech Computer Science and Engineering. I don't know, there may be other university also, but our university is the first one in Central India which provided the specialization for artificial intelligence and machine learning in their BTech Honors program, which is known as what? BTech Honors means Bachelor of Technology Honors program, right? So, हम BTech Honors हम program offer करते हैं अपने students को, right? उस program में हम बच्चों को computer science को पढ़ाते हैं, but हम specialization subject क्या पढ़ाते हैं? Artificial intelligence and machine learning. This is really a dynamic program from the, you know, future perspective, from the career perspective, from any kind of, you know, if we talk about the upcoming 2 or 3 years, it is the era of artificial intelligence only. Everything is going to be take place in artificial intelligence. Every industry has started to implement the artificial intelligence and machine learning algorithm. So I hope you have enjoyed this lecture. And if there is any question, any doubt, any query in your mind regarding artificial intelligence, you can just tell me.
Sir, here I would like to present one question. It is asked by one of our students. So the question is, if a person is not good or interested in coding, then should the person move for artificial intelligence?
Yeah, that's a very nice question. And I will do it. Definitely, I would like to give the answer of this question. If he or she is not interested in coding, right? So without interest, you know, nothing happens, right? Without interest, if I'm not having the interest in my, you know, particular coding skills and I have been enrolled in the computer science engineering, then you know, there may be a lot of difficulties which I should face, right? बहुत सारी difficulties आ सकती हैं यदि मैंने coding अच्छे से अपने basics में clear नहीं किए हैं. लेकिन मैं आपको एक बात बताना चाहता हूँ, at the level of 12th or 11th or whatever you are pursuing, right? वहाँ पे हमें coding का importance समझ में नहीं आता है, right? When you go to the your graduation kind of thing, right? Once there, when you have been introduced with a lot of applications of coding, the lot of applications of AI and machine learning, a lot of things. वहाँ पे आपका एक interest जगाने का जो duty होती है, वो भी हमारी होती है, that you should have this particular coding skill. Why? Because you will have a lot of career opportunity in this particular thing, right? So coding में भी आपका interest नहीं है, no problem. कोडिंग की जगह आप प्रॉब्लम, आप अपना इंटरेस्ट दिखाइए रियल लाइफ प्रॉब्लम को फाइंड आउट करने में. यदि आपने रियल लाइफ प्रॉब्लम फाइंड आउट करी और आपको उसका कोई सॉल्यूशन आपके मन में है, तो आप खुद ही खुद अपने मन में उसको कोडिंग के लिए यू नो सर्च आउट करना स्टार्ट कर देंगे, कोडिंग को एक्सप्लोर करना स्टार्ट कर देंगे, राइट? तो एट दिस लेवल वी कांट से दैट कि वी डोंट हैव द इंटरेस्ट इन कोडिंग. व्हाई? बिकॉज़ अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स हैज टू बी एक्सप्लोर्ड येट. अभी तक आपने कोडिंग मेरे ख्याल से सी और सी प्लस प्लस ही पढ़ी होगी, यदि पढ़ी होगी तो, राइट? बट उसके आगे आपने कोडिंग नहीं देखी. ये जो कोडिंग थी, दैट वाज अ वेरी टिपिकल काइंड ऑफ कोडिंग. बट नाउ व्हाट इज हैपनिंग, डू यू नो पाइथन? पाइथन इज अ बेस्ट ओपन सोर्स लैंग्वेज विच इज अवेलेबल नाउअडेज, राइट? और जब आप पाइथन में जाएंगे तो उसका सिंटैक्स बहुत ईजी होता है, उसकी लैंग्वेज बहुत ईजी होती है, इट इज मोर लाइक अ ह्यूमन लैंग्वेज, फाइन? वहां पे आपको कोडिंग के लिए बहुत ज्यादा टिपिकल सिंटैक्स यूज करने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी, फाइन? So I will just recommend you, if you are not having a good interest in coding, then I will just recommend you try, give you one chance to become a, you know, AI engineer. And in that perspective, then you will explore a lot of open source languages. You will definitely have the interest in coding, right?